In this session, we are going to solve the next problem of exercise 6, which is 4th question. And what's the question given here? A water pipe covers a distance of 62.5 km, consuming 1 liter of petrol. How much distance does it cover for 10 liters of petrol? It's a very easy problem. Here, what's saying here? The motor pipe travels a distance of 62.5 km by using 1 liter of petrol. Now here, you need to find the total distance. If you take 10 liters of petrol, how much distance the motor bike will travel, you need to find it. And you know that, just you need to multiply these two values so that you will get, with 10 liters of petrol, how much distance the motor bike will travel. So here, just multiply here 62.5 into 10. So here, before the session also we have discussed, if you are multiplying one decimal number with 10, you need to shift this decimal point as many of the zeros. Here since 10 is there, you need to shift this decimal point to the right one number. So here, this decimal point you need to keep it here. So what will get here? 625 kilometers. So with 1 liter of petrol, the motor bike is traveling a distance of 62.5 kilometers. And in the question they asked, with 10 liters of petrol, how much the distance the motorbike has to travel. For that, just you need to take the multiplication of these two values so that we are getting here 625 kilometers is the distance that is traveled by the motorbike by using the 10 liters of the petrol. Now write the problem here. So writing here, with 1 liter of petrol, the distance traveled by the motor bike you many numbers are there. Here after the decimal point, here one number is there, and here after the decimal point, one number is there. So two numbers are there. Now starting from the right, count two numbers. So here it is one and it is two. Before that, keep the decimal point. So the value of this one is 4.75. Like this, you need to find. Now see here one more question. Here the third question. Here, what is the third question given here? 0.2 into 210.8. Just write it. What we have done before? Write the numbers leaving the decimal point. So here, what is there? 2, and here what is there? 2108. Now make the product of these two values. What you get? 2 8s are 16, and similarly 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4. So we got it here 4216. Now here after the decimal point, how many numbers are there? Here one and here one. So two numbers are there. Now starting from the right, count two numbers 1 and 2 before you keep the decimal point. So what will be the answer here? 42.16. Like this, you need to solve here the fourth question, fifth question, and sixth question. This you can do it as a homework. So here, see the next question. So what is the homework? In the exercise 6, in the 5th question, you can do the 4th one, 5th one, and the 6th one. And after that, the 7th one also you can do it. And see the 8th one. So what is the 8th question given here? 10.05 into 1.05. So you need to find this value. So leave the decimal point. So what you get here? 1005 into here, what is there here? 105. You need to make the product of these values, and you know that how to do the calculation. First you need to multiply 5 to this number, and after that you need to multiply with 0, and after that you need to multiply with 5. So here 5 5 is 25, 5 2 5 0 0, and 5 1s are 5. Now here you need to keep the symbol, and after that 0 multiplied to any number is 0, so 0 0 0 0, and after that multiplied with 1, you will get the same number. So here 5 0 0 1. So what you got it here? 5 2 5 5 0 1. So after multiplication we got this answer. So write it here 105 5 2 5. Now what is our next step? You need to count after the decimal point how many numbers are there. So count it here. After the decimal point, here 1 and 2, and here also 1 and 2. Total 4 numbers are there after the decimal point. So starting from the right, count 4 numbers here. So here 1, 2, 3, 4. Before that you need to keep the decimal point. Like this you need to find if you make the product of any two decimal numbers. Now see the 10th question. This one you can do it as a homework. And the 9th question you can do it as a homework. And the 10th question also you can do it. Like this you need to make the product of the two decimal numbers. How do you do? Just leave the decimal point and find the product of the given numbers. And after that, after the decimal point, how many numbers are there counted? And starting from the right, that many numbers you need to put. Before that you need to keep the decimal point. Like that you need to make the product of the given decimal numbers. Now see the 6th question here. Here in the 6th question, they have given the decimal number divided by some numbers. That means they have divided two decimal number with some numbers. You need to find that value. So here in the first question, 2.3 divided by 100. Here in the case of multiplication, we have shifted this decimal point to the right that many of the zeros. In the case of the division, you need to shift this decimal point to the left as the many of the zeros. Just reverse here. So here, that method you can follow, or otherwise you can do the normal calculation. How do you do the normal calculation? First check it here. You can write this 2.3 as 23 by 10. Right? Since after the decimal point one number is there, in the denominator you need to keep it here 10. So after that divide it by 100. So what you get here 23/10. In case of division, if you keep the multiplication, you need to write the reciprocal of this number. What is meant by the reciprocal? Just change the numerator into the denominator and the denominator into the numerator. And you know that it is nothing but 100/1. So what is this value? 1/100. Now multiply it. We have already learned in this fraction chapter how do you multiply two fractions. Just you need to multiply the numerators and you need to multiply the denominators. So here what will get here? 23 into 1, which gives you 23. 10 into 100, which is 1000. Now you know that how to write this one in the form of the decimal form. So here in the denominator, how many zeros are there? 1, 2, 3. So in the numerator, you need to go that many numbers to the from the right, and before that you need to keep the decimal point. So what is the result here, which is 23? Since you need to move three numbers, 1, 2, the third number is not there, keep it 0. Before that you need to keep the decimal point. Like this you need to do. This is the normal division if you have given any decimal number and the whole number. And if you want to do the process, the other process, which is shifting method, 2.3 divided by 100, as we have discussed now here. Since here two zeros are there, you need to shift this decimal point two numbers to the left. So here what is the number here, which is 23, and two zeros are there, here 10, and here one number is there. Before that you need to keep one more number, and after that you keep the decimal point. Just we have got the answer in one step. Here what we need to do here, you need to count how many zeros are there. Since we are doing the division, you need to shift this decimal point to the left, that many of the zeros, and before that you need to keep the decimal point. Now see here the next question. The second one, what they have given, 0.45 divided by 5. So here you need to find the division of these two numbers. So here write it here, you can write 0.45 as 45/100, because after the decimal point two numbers are there, in the denominator keep two zeros. Divided by 5/1, you can write 5 as 5/1. So here what will get? 45/100. In case of division, keep multiplication, so you need to reverse the number. 5/1, you have to write it as 1/5. Now you can observe that here 5 1s and 5 9s will get cancelled. 5 9s are 45. So here you will get 9/100. So what is the value of 9/100? Which is nothing but, since two zeros are there, before two numbers keep the decimal point. So this will be the answer. Now see the next question, which is third question. Here the third question is similar to that of the first question in the sixth problem. So you can do it this one. In the sixth question, the third one, you can do it. Now see the fourth question. Here what they have given? 127.1 divided by 1000. So here there are two methods. We will solve by using the two methods. And the first method, just do the normal division. How do you solve this one? So you can write this one as 1271/10, because after the decimal point one number is there, keep 10. And after that, this one you can write it as 1000/1. Now change this division into multiplication. So into, just reverse the number, what will get here? 1/1000. Now here you know that how to multiply two fractions, just multiply the numerator. So what will get? 1271 into 1, which is this one, and 10 into 1000, which gives you 10,000. So here write the numerator 1271, and count here in the denominator how many zeros are there. How many zeros are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 zeros are there. So starting from the right, count 4 numbers, and before that keep the decimal point. So here 1, 2, 3, 4, keep it here decimal point. This will be the answer. Now here there is the other method to solve the same problem, which is 127.1 divided by 1000. within one step you can do this one. Here, so if you are dividing with 1000, you need to shift this decimal point as many of the zeros. Since here how many zeros are there? 3 zeros are there. You need to shift this decimal point 3 numbers to the left. So here, shift it here 1, 2, 3. So you have to get here the decimal point. The answer will be 0.1273. So this method also you can follow it, or this method also you can follow it. Just count how many zeros are there, and you need to shift this decimal point to the left that many of the zeros, and before that you need to keep the decimal point. Now see here the next question, fifth question.
Here also we can do it many of the methods.
So here you can observe here after the decimal point one number is there in the numerator and after the decimal point one number is there in the denominator. So here since after the decimal point the numbers are same, you can remove this decimal point or you can cancel this decimal point. Directly you can write this one as 175/35. So here you know that 35 × 5 which gives you 175. You can check it here. 35 × 5, 5 × 5, 25. 2 × 5 = 14 + 2 which gives you 17. So this one will get cancelled. You will get the answer as 5. So here this one you can write as 175/35 because here after the decimal point in both the numerator and the denominator the if you count there will be the only one number. So you can remove the decimal point or you can cancel the decimal point. This one you can directly write it as 175/35. What is 175/35? Which gives you here 5. So here how many sides does the polygon have? Which is the 5 sides. Like this you can calculate or you can do the normal division. How to solve 17.5/3.5. So you can after doing this one you can observe that this is the small quadrant. You can solve it here. This one you can write it as 175/10 divided by you can write this one as 35/10. And again if you change into multiplication you need to write the reciprocal. So write it here 175/10 × 10/35. So here this 10 will get cancelled. 35 × 35 = 5. Which gives you 5. Thus, you can do any of these methods for the calculation. Now see here, the last problem in this exercise. So this one you can do it as a homework. Just I will explain how to solve this problem, which is the 8th question. So what's the 8th question given here? A rainfall of 0.896 cm was recorded in 7 hours. In 7 hours, how much the rainfall was recorded here, which is 0.896 cm. Now here, they ask what was the average amount of rain per 1 hour. You need to calculate here for 1 hour, what is the average rainfall. Now here for 1 hour, that means you need to divide these two values so that in 1 hour, how much the average rainfall you need to get it here. So divide it with 0.896/7. Just you can do the any of the methods. So here you can write this one as 896/1000/7. Now change the division into multiplication so that you will get the answer. This one you can do it. If you have any doubt you can ask. From this session is